Hi, this is Mato. Welcome to my online chess lecture. In this video, I will show you a game between Magnus Carlsen and Yu Yang-Yi. This is a game from the Norway Chess Tournament 2019. Magnus Carlsen had white pieces and he started with d4. Yu Yang-Yi played d5, c4, Queen's Gambit, c6, the Slav defense. Knight to f3, knight to f6, knight to c3, d takes on c4. White to move. a4 is the most played move, preventing b5. Carlsen played e4, not worried about b5. White to move. e5 is the most played move, attacking the knight and making the room for the knight to go to e4. Carlsen played bishop to e2. b4. e5. b takes on c3. E takes on f6. This is the first critical moment of the game. It is black to move. Pawn takes pawn on f6 was played. In the past, black had good results with c takes on b2. After bishop takes on b2, both e takes on f6 and queen to a5 check are good for black. Back to our game. Pawn takes pawn on f6. Pawn takes pawn on c3. White has a better pawn structure. Bishop to d6 and both players castled kingside. It is white to move. Bishop takes on c4 immediately is possible. Carlsen played knight to d2, intending knight to c4, and he also wants to play bishop to f3, applying the pressure on the pawn on c6. Rook to e8, rook to e1. Knight to d7, knight takes on c4. Bishop to c7, bishop to f3. Bishop to a6, knight to e3, knight to b6. Is this a blunder? White can take on c6. Carlsen played bishop to a3. Why? Would you take on c6 in this position if you had white pieces or not? If bishop takes on c6, then queen to d6, threatening to take on h2, and after g3, queen takes bishop. Back to our game. Bishop to a3, preventing queen to d6. It is black to move. Knight to c4 was played. Well, queen to d7 should have been considered. Knight to c4. Queen to d3. Let's take it back. Bishop takes on c6 is fine now. Because queen to d6 doesn't work anymore, does it? Bishop takes queen. And let's go back. In this position, black can play knight takes on a3, but then queen to a4, and white is better. Back to our game. After knight to c4, queen to d3, rook takes on e3. Rook takes on e3. Let's take it back. If pawn takes on e3, then knight takes on a3. And after queen takes bishop, knight to c2. Back to our game. Rook takes on e3. Knight takes on e3. Queen takes bishop on a6. Knight to c2. Rook to d1. Knight takes on a3. Queen takes on a3. White is threatening to take on c6. Queen to d6 was played. If queen to d7, then queen to a4. And after rook to c8, d5. White is better. Queen to d6, defending the pawn and threatening to take on h2. This is also offering to exchange queens. Queen takes on d6, bishop takes on d6, and now, not bishop takes on c6, c4. If bishop takes on c6, rook to c8, attacking the bishop and extraing the pawn on c3. After d5, rook to b8. This position was not to Carlsen's liking. Back to our game. So in this position, c4 was played. Rook to c8. If now rook to b8, then c5, after bishop to e7, bishop takes on c6, is very strong. Back to our game. Rook to c8. c5, bishop to e7. King to f1, intending to centralize the king. f5, king to e2. g5, h3, king to g7, king to d3. Note how the black rook is tied up on defending the pawn on c6. King to g6, rook to b1, h5, rook to b7. Against Carlsen, this position is lost for black. It is just a question how many moves black can play before resigning. Bishop to f6. And now rook to d7. Very clever move, preventing black from playing rook to d8. The game continued. g4. Bishop to d1. King to g5. Bishop to a4. Let's take it back. If rook takes on f7, then rook to d8 is unpleasant for white. Back to our game. Bishop to a4. No rush to take the pawn on f7. f4. f3. Rook to e8. F takes on g4. H takes on g4. Even rook to e3 check doesn't help. Then king to c4. H takes on g4. H takes on g4. And if king takes now on g4, then rook takes on f7. White is winning. Back to our game. H takes on g4. H takes on g4. Rook to e6. White to move. There is more than one way to win. Bishop to d1 was played. Rook to c7 and king to c4 are also winning. Bishop to d1. Rook to e3 check. King to c4. a5 saving the pawn. Bishop to f3. Rook to a3. Bishop takes on c6. Rook takes on a2. Bishop to e4, preventing rook to c2 check and clearing the path for the pawn. a4, c6, rook to a1. Now intending rook to c1 check in some variations. c7, a3. White to move. White played the move and black resigned. Carlsen played king to b3 and you resigned. One line goes like this. Rook to c1. Rook to d5, check. King takes on g4. Rook to c5. Rook takes rook. D takes on c5. And there is no way to stop the pawn from promoting. If a2, white promotes with check. And I guess we can stop here. And let's go back to one of the critical positions of the game. This is the position. It looks like that the adventurous knight to c4 didn't work well for black. What do you think of this game? And that is all. I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. I wish you good luck with your chess, and bye for now.